Good evening. Today I'm going to do Form 5, Chapter 4, Matrices. It's very important. And SPM, every year they will ask in Paper 1 and Paper 2. Normally, carry 2 to 3 marks. Paper 2, Section A, carry 6 marks. Altogether 9 marks is very important. So only for aspect, okay, only for aspect. First aspect, you must know how to add a minus. Second is a times. Third, you must know identity and inverse. And finally, solve simultaneous equation. Solve simultaneous equation by matrix method. So only for aspect, okay. So I'm going to start with the introduction. Okay, introduction. Okay, first of all, you must know the order. Order, okay. Order means rows times column. Columns, okay. So row times column, this called order. In Malay, we call peringkat. Peringkat. Peringkat adalah baris darab lajur. Baris darab lajur. Okay. So example, let's say I give you A, B, C, D, E, F. Okay, this called row 1, row 2, row 3. In Malay call baris 1, baris 2, baris 3. Ini dipanggil lajur 1, okay. Okay, column 1, column 2. In baris in Malay call baris mean lajur 1, lajur 2. So whenever say order, order means row times column. So 3 row times 2. This is introduction. So first of all, everybody must know order. Order means row times column, 3 row, 2 column. Right? Okay, that is called order. In Malay called peringkat. Dua, tiga kali dua. Second, under introduction, you must know the equal matrix. Dalam bahasa Melayu, matrix sama. Equal matrix means, so the, okay, the order must be same. Order must be same. And, okay, corresponding element must be same. Corresponding element are same. Meaning, okay, meaning let's say I give you A, B, C, D, P, Q, R, S. So this is called, equal matrix A equals to P, B equals to Q, C equals to R, D equals to S. This is called equal matrix. Alright, so after I will explain, I will show you how the question asks you. So this is called equal matrix. Equal matrix means the order must be same. Mean 2 times 2, this also 2 times 2. Corresponding element are same. A equals to P, B equals to Q, C equals to R, and D equals to S. Okay, and third one under your introduction. Okay, so whenever they give one matrix and one number outside, the number need to times each number inside. So what I mean? K times A, K, A, K times B, K, B, K times C, K, C, K times D, K, D. So, any element they given outside on matrix, okay, each element mean, outside the number, need to times each element inside the bracket. That's under introduction. So, I going to start now, okay, addition and subtraction of matrix. So, whenever addition and subtraction matrix, order must be same. My order must be same. If not same, order must be same. If not same, we cannot add or minus. Okay, how to add or minus? We must add or minus corresponding element. Okay, so what's the meaning of this? Let's see. Whenever add or minus A, B, C, D, P, Q, R, S. Whenever add, you need to minus, okay, plus corresponding element. That means A plus P, B plus Q, C plus R, D plus S. Every year they will ask this one in the paper 1. Alright? Objective. Alright. If plus this is the method, minus also same. If minus means, okay, here need to minus, 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 minus. Okay, example I give you now. In exam they give you 4, 3, 2, 1. The plus 1, 5, 7, 8. So whenever add or minus, you need to minus, okay, add same corresponding element. 4 plus 1, okay, 3 plus 5, 2 plus 7, 1 plus 8. So, the final answer will be 5, 8, 9, 9, okay. That means 4 plus 1, 3 plus 5, 2 plus 7, 1 plus 8. So, it will be 5, 8, 9, 9. Okay, this is a way to add. Even minus also same thing. You need to minus, minus 1, minus 1, minus 1, minus 1, get answer. So that's all for addition and subtraction. So addition, subtraction, always remember order must be same. If not same, we cannot add or minus. And whenever add or minus, must add or minus the corresponding element. That's for addition and subtraction. And second is times. Okay, times, very simple. Always remember row times column and order. So this is a keyword to remember for times. Okay. And for example, I'll give you now example. Or before example, I'll give you notes. Alright. Whenever times, let's say this is A, B, P, Q. So whenever times, you need to times like this. Row times column. So how to times? Okay. A times B, A, P, B times Q, B, Q. So we need times like this. So every time you draw the arrow, so K show that. So you'll remember how to times A times B plus B times Q. If I give you R and S, same thing, unit times and write that side. So for example, so unit times A times R plus B times S. This is a way to times whenever they give like this. Okay, sometimes they give you down also, C and D. So assume, okay, on top you don't have. So same thing, unit times. It's now C times P, C, P plus D times Q, D, Q. Then C times R, C, R plus D times S, D, S. This is a way to times. Okay, I think we understand how to times. Okay, anyway, I give a simple example. So you will understand, okay, more. Okay, I give you a simple example. Okay, sometimes they give you just like this. For information, 1, 2, 3, 4. Whenever they give like this, you just, okay, times like this, okay, row times column. So 1 times 3, so today you can write 3, no need to write 1 times 3, again, no need to show the times, okay, plus 2 times 4, 2 times 4, right? And this is a way to times. Whenever they give, sometimes they give just like this, okay, number, so 1 times 3 plus 2 times 4. Okay, let's say they give 5, 1. So same thing, you need times, okay, like this, 1 times 5, you need to give, get here, alright, and then 2 times 1, alright, so that's the way, whenever they give like this, you need to row times, every time draw the arrow, so don't be mistake, row times column, okay, let's say I give you now 6, 0, so assume you don't have the up one, so you just times like this, 6 times 3, plus 0 times 4, then 6 times 5 plus 0 times 1, then you calculate, you get the answer. That's a way to do times. I think everybody understand how to times, all right, or multiplication. So here come 3 plus 2 will be 8, 11, 5 plus 2 will be 7, 18 plus 0 will be 18, 30, 30 plus 0 will become 30. So this is a way to times. I think we understand how to times. Alright? That's the times. Just remember this. Because sometimes they just give like this. Okay, just times. Right. Okay, if they give like this, you times again. So this is a way to times. Alright? Okay, times finish. Third one, we go. Identity. Identity and inverse. Alright. So first of all, you must understand what's mean identity. Identity in matrix means... means is 1, okay, but okay, 1, they have to write the 1, they will write 1 0 0 1, 1 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 1. So always the first diagonal everything will be 1, the rest will be 0. This is called identity. Alright, so identity means 1. That's why any matrix you times the identity, or identity you times the matrix, you get back the A. So what's the meaning of this? Identity is I stand for identity. Any matrix you times the identity, okay, 7, 9, you times 1, 0, 0, 1, you will get, definitely get back the same answer. 4, 5, 7, 9. So whatever number you times the identity, you get back this answer, because this whole thing we consider is 1. Okay, the meaning identity is 1. That's why you, after, okay, you times and see, you'll get this answer. That's all. Need to remember identity. Nothing else for identity. Alright, then inverse. We go inverse. So inverse actually in nowadays, okay, you got actually got two form of quotients. Okay. One we can say there is a formula. This formula in exam they'll give you, so no need to remember. Alright. So inverse, the formula is A, B, C, D. The formula is 1 over your times the first diagonal times A times D minus B times C. Then the first diagonal exchange the position, D will go up, A will come down. And then the C and B is not change the position. A lot of students already change, is not change. Only diagonal, first diagonal change the position. The second diagonal is not change the position, just put a negative. This formula in exam they'll give you, so no need to memorize. Okay, I give simple example so you will understand. Okay, now I give an example now. In exam they will ask you inverse. Inverse 2 4 1 6. An example will give you. So whenever they give like this, the formula is 1 over okay 2 times 4 minus 6 times 1. 6 times 1. Then just now I said, see the formula 1 over A times D minus B times C. The D and A will change the position. That means the 4 will go up, 2 will come down. Then 6 and 1, you need to put a negative. So answer will be 1, 8 minus 6, you get it 2, 4, negative 6, negative 1, 2. Actually, you can leave the answer like this, but more, okay, simplify. The number need to times each number inside the bracket. 1 over 2 times 4, you get it 2, 1 over 2 times 6, negative 3, 1 over 2 times negative 1, negative 1 over 2, 1 over 2 times 2, you get it 1. So this is the final answer. So this is one of the question very popular. Every year 100% they will ask you inverse. 100%. So this is a formula to find inverse. Okay, I told you we got two form question. One is inverse. Okay, formula. Another one they will give you A times I or I times A. Sorry. A times inverse A. Inverse A times A, you will get an identity. So what's the meaning of this? So identity is 1001. So matrix A, this is called matrix A. So matrix A, this is an inverse matrix A. So you will get a 1001. So how the question asks you for information? They'll give you like this. Okay, example now. They give, okay, I give the same question. 2, 6, 1, 4. They'll give one matrix. They don't give this one. They will say this is a matrix B. And they'll give you 1, 0, 0, 1. Okay, to get a matrix B, matrix B is inverse of matrix 2, 6, 1, 4. So therefore just do inverse of 2, 1, 6, 4. Okay, just now I taught you how to do inverse. Use the formula, same thing. That means in exam I never see 1, 0, 0, 1. They give one matrix, they ask besides what's the matrix of this. You just do inverse for the matrix A, you will get the answer. So it's important, you must see here 1001. Here 1001, give one matrix, the ask beside is just do inverse of the matrix A. Okay, that's all for the inverse. And finally, the fourth aspect is solve simultaneous equation by matrix method. So what's the meaning of this? So simultaneous equation. So for example, in exam they give you AX plus BY equals to K, CX plus DY equals to H. They ask, they will use the word by matrix method. So by matrix method mean the A, B, C, D, you write down under one bracket A, B, C, D. The X, Y write down here, then K, H here. So you want to find the X, Y, you just take this, okay, matrix, you do inverse here. 1 over, you do this matrix inverse, AD minus BC. D will go up, A will come down. So negative B, negative C, then times KH. This is a, okay, solve, you get the answer. This is a formula. Okay, I'll give a simple example for this. So these are steps to do solve simple multiplication by matrix method. Okay, I give one simple SPM questions. Okay, this is SPM question. They'll give you 2x minus 3y equals to negative 4. Okay, 4x plus 5y equals to 14. They will say this example. They will say this, you do by matrix method. Okay, how to do? Actually, you can use elimination method, substitution method, three method. So, but whenever say matrix method, you must use matrix method. Okay, this negative 3, this a 4, this a 5, x, y. When you try, 2 times x to x, negative 3 times y, 3 y, get back this answer. So, negative 4, 14. So, first step, you need like 2, negative 3, 4, 5 is here, x, y, negative 4, 14. After that, you want to find the x, y. So, what you do, you need to find here inverse. Yesterday, bring after the equation. After the equation, so do inverse for this. So, you all know how to do inverse, 2 times 5. Then minus 4 times negative 3. Okay, so I straight away write down because not enough space. So, already decide. Okay, so xy, you have to find xy, you need to do inverse of this. So, 2 times 5 minus 4 times negative 3. Then 5 will go up, 2 will come down. The negative negative, here got negative, so you need to write according to the formula, you need to write negative. Okay, 4, negative 4, and times negative 4, 14. Then you solve, you get the answer. How to solve? You just do, this will be 10 minus, this will be 10, this will be 12, 22. Positive 22, 5, positive 3, negative 4, 2, then negative 4, 14. Then you solve, how to solve? Just times, you get the answer. That's it. So that's chapter 5. Matrices completely finish this topic. That's a concept. Bye.